As the government, through the Ministry of Lands, Housing and Urban Development, sought to identify gaps and challenges in the current national land policy's implementation, stakeholders have unanimously proposed that the government should consider urban agriculture in a bid to optimally use and manage Uganda's land resources.
So, as we plan the review of the national urban policy, this need to encourage people to embrace aspects of urban agriculture. Gardens, we can use box gardens to ensure that we have food security in our households. Our neighbors, Kenya here, are already embracing it, whereby the Kenya County government has entered into MOUs with the communities in informal settlements to utilize the road reserves.
This is where we need to re-evaluate the traditional thinking of vacant land, because now the emerging question is that this vacant land is an asset and this land can be stimulate economic development and also will have an opportunity for infilling by new developers. When it comes to the question from Brian about the use of agricultural land, these are the strategies that other cities have taken to maintain that vacant land, but for a socio-economic purpose.
Charting the policy's way forward in the next implementation phase, the Deputy Chief Executive Officer of Buganda Land Board, Bashir Juma Kizito, noted that urban agriculture is reliably viable and should be highly considered.
When we talk about urban agriculture, then we're thinking about innovative approaches of how to do it. Yes, so, and it's very, very optimal. We know we can use small spaces, we can use the green spaces we have to promote green sceneries, but at the same time, exploiting the potential to have agriculture outputs out of it.
So on the other side of the coin, Sam Stewart Mutabazi, a transportation planner from the Uganda Road Sector Support Initiative, noted that as urban agriculture is prioritized for consideration, it has to be done carefully not to interfere with the market systems.
If you want to do agriculture in the true sense of the word, then you need to make sure that it is well organized, it has space, a space where it can be done, it doesn't inconvenience other people.
So you could also say, okay, you could also zone and say the business, and say that probably maybe the business district shouldn't have urban agriculture.
However, the Uganda Community-Based Association for Women and Children Welfare, UKABAK, called for more observance of women land rights as drafted in the National Land Policy. Evidence reveals that there is still a gap between the policy provisions and implementation as relates to the gender strategy.
The policies are progressive, whereas the policies have provisions that really support women's land rights. We are yet to actualize that in real practice because of so many reasons, such as norms and customs, because interventions in ministry or in this sector that are aimed to spearhead those policy interventions are not well funded.
The National Land Policy, approved by Cabinet in February 2013, has been a cornerstone in shaping Uganda's land management and utilization strategies. The Lands Minister, Judith Nabakoba, said that this platform would present an opportunity to evaluate the policy's impact and identify areas for improvement to better serve the nation's needs. Derek Asaba, reporting for the news.